Hello and welcome to the second part of this tutorial. If you missed part 1, you can click here and watch it. In this video, we're going to talk about advanced picture composing and also how to put your figures into your text. I have two examples for you. The first one is going to be a sensor that had problems with one contact. And the second one is some comparison of plants in a table. Let's start with our pictures. We have four pictures that we want to combine in a figure, and we want to have the figure with the same width as our text frame to fill the whole area of the frame. Therefore, we need to figure out how wide is our text frame. We can see this in the InDesign document. If we just select the frame, we can see it's 165 millimeters wide. If we divide 165 by 4, we get 41.25 millimeters. So each picture needs to be 41.25 millimeters wide. Then we also need to create again some labeling for each subpicture. And we also want to include a scale in here that says 1 millimeter. And we also want to create a scale for our port where we plug in our sensors. Finally, we're going to create some arrows that point out some interesting features in our figure. We start by creating a picture frame that should be 41.25 millimeters wide. We don't care so much about the height at the moment. We can take care of this later. Then we're going to copy this one 3 times. And use the align tool to get the alignment right. With the separation of 0 millimeters, I can distribute them aligned to each other. Now I drop the pictures in and insert them into the frames. We can double click to rescale the picture. If you hold down the shift key, you can make sure to rotate it by 90 degrees. Place the picture how you want to have them. Now you can copy the scaling and apply the scaling to the other pictures. We need to rotate them again. And we're going to try to get them aligned. To make sure they have all the same position, we can also use guidelines to see if they are looking good. They are aligned quite good at the moment, so we can delete this again. Now we take care of the port. We need to reduce the size and also rotate it a little bit. This should be fine. Alright, now we get some labeling on here. We are using a text box and we're using the paragraph style we used before in the toolbox, the ABC. And we call this one VE1. Makes alignment in the center using 1 PT border. And also we need to have a white background. Something like this. This looks alright. So we can copy this one for the other two pictures. And we call our electrode B. Here we need to reduce the size of the box a little bit. Now we take care of the alignment. We do it the same way we did in the video before. Align it to the corners for each picture. Select our boxes. Press the Shift key and select the pictures again to only select our boxes and move them down 5 arrows and 5 arrows to the right. Now the labeling is done. We need to take care of our scale. The second picture has the scale included. We're going to copy this one and drag the picture so we see the scale. We need to rotate it 90 degrees. And now we use the line tool to create a scale. By holding the Shift key, we can make sure to create a straight line. We want to have a 2 PT thick. Then we can copy this line and make it black. Now we use the line tool to align both lines to each other. We can use again the spacing of 0, and now they're close together. Then we create a text and write 1 mm is the scale. We need to reduce the size and we want to create a new paragraph style for this text. We can put this one in the toolbox and call it scale. Now we need to position the text box above our lines. Deselect the background picture and we use the align tool. Can move this down a little bit. And then we group it. Zoom out. And we place this one in the left corner of our picture. We're using again the align trick here and the 5 arrows up and 5 arrows to the right. We're creating a scale for the other picture in the same way. You can also copy the scale and adjust it for the other picture. Finally, you want to create some arrows to point out that these scratches over here are not from this contact, because the scratches are on the other two contacts as well. To create an arrow, we use the line tool, hold the Shift key to drag it in 45 degrees, and we change the length to 5 mm. Then we set the line to 1 PT thickness, and using the stroke panel to give it an arrow head. To the start, we're using triangle. Every time we're going to use an arrow in our thesis, we're going to use this one and copy it and place it on our picture. So we can point out things with this arrow to show that we have the scratches on all three electrodes. Then we hold down the Shift key again and rotate this arrow and point out that this contact here is bent down. We should give this arrow another color to say, for example, in the image description, the green arrow points out the broken contact. We can move down this arrow a little bit more. And now we're basically done. We group this picture. Now we would put it in the text frame and give the picture a description. Now it's time to take care of our second example, with the plants that are arranged in kind of a table structure, with some text on the left side and the top describing what we are seeing here. We need to figure out how big our picture should be to have the whole figure filling the whole text frame. For the labeling on the left, we take a distance of 6 mm, so we subtract from our text width the 6 mm. Then we have a spacing between the pictures and the labeling as well, the standard spacing of 3 mm. We also need to subtract these. We end up with 150, and we need to divide this 150 by 3, and we see each picture should be 50 mm wide. Now we can place the pictures into InDesign. First we're going to place one single picture, and we set the width to 50 mm. Now we have the right aspect ratio. We're going to delete the picture inside and copy this box to create a 4x3 arrangement. Now we need to arrange the picture boxes, so we'll select one column and use our align tool, and we set the distance here to 3 mm. Then we're going to group this one and do the same with the other boxes. Then we select all boxes and also get the vertical spacing to 3 mm and align them to the top edges. Then we need to ungroup the boxes again. Now we can place our pictures into InDesign. Select all pictures and click on this symbol. If you want, you can still adjust some of the pictures to make them look better. The labeling is done by tables, and we're going to talk about the labeling in the next tutorial. Now it's time to get the figures into the text. We're going to select the whole figure and copy it, and go to the place where we want to insert it. Get into the text and place the figure. This doesn't look right at the moment, but we select the figure again and go on Anchored Object. There are options, and we want to make some custom settings. We want to arrange it on the button on the page, so we say relative to Y on text frame. Now it gets arranged on the button of the page. This looks fine, so we can go on OK. And now we press this button to get the text flowing around our figure. We need to move it down a little bit to be aligned with the edge of our text frame. And now we see here that the text is too close to our figure. So what we need to do is to be selected again, and we go on this panel, this is text wrap, and we say it should be on top 5 mm, so it inserts some border and the text flows around it better. If you would type something in here, the text will automatically flow to the next page. If you use a smaller figure, it solves the same thing. But now we don't make any further settings in here, and we move the figure up a little bit to match the text cap in here. We're going to set the text wrap to 5 mm again. But if we zoom now on our figure, we see that the first line isn't wrapped around our figure. This is because the figure is linked here, and everything above this symbol isn't affected by the figure concerning text wrapping. So we need to move this down a little bit. And we also need to move down the figure again. Make sure to select the text frame and there we go. Let's assume you have a figure that is filling one whole page. This gets a little bit tricky now. You need to insert a page break at the end of a page, and then you need to insert a page break again. Now you can take the figure and put it between those two page breaks. If you assign the paragraph style font to this piece of text, it will be perfectly aligned. If we type now on the pages before, it will mess up our layout. So we need to make sure to check that every picture is where it should be. Unfortunately, I did run out of time for this video, but there are still some things you should know about placing pictures. So there will be a third part of this video, and you can click here to watch it.